Oh, that's it. That's it. Now that's a better fish there. Woo, and he stinks.
Hook. Put that fish.
maybe we should drop shot that thing.
Oh boy.
He short sticked me. He got me right at the boat. Yeah, baby. This little buck right here come flying out from under that dock to smack this little BWA submission swim bait right here. In case you guys haven't noticed, we are back out here with my buddy Matt Frazier. Today we're gonna get Matt talking on film. We're on Matt's boat today. Last time when we were at Toll, like what, January?
January, yep.
It was tough, and he goes, dude, quit putting me in these tough situations. But today we're out here at Lake Dalval in Livermore. This is a lake I grew up fishing, and I was telling Matt, dude, the last time I fished it, I was probably 13 years old, and I'm pretty sure I didn't catch a bass like on the second or third cast at that time either.
Yeah.
What is today? April 6th?
6th.
April 6th, as I was walking from parking the truck, I seen some fish on beds. That fish was a pre-spawn fish, so it looks like we're going to have a lot of fun today. It's supposed to be like 90-something?
91, I think.
91? Yeah, 90-something, 91. 90-something, it's yeah. The same difference, same bro. But Matt, you know, Matt's, what are you fishing now? What events are you fishing, man?
Oh, I do a little, I still participate in the Future Pro events, but I did just get back from the One Bass Open at Clear Lake. We did that one, and that was...
And how many double-digit fish do you already have for 2016, Matt?
I have three, and there's been five out of my boat.
There's been five out of his boat, and he's got three already, yep. And it's the beginning of April. So we're probably going to do some bed fishing, some pre-spawn styles of fishing, and break it down along the way for you guys, and hopefully put some big fish on film, so stay with us. Matt's going to educate you. I'm going to educate you. I think we're going to have a blast today.
Ooh. Oh, he hit it. So what Matt and I are doing is we're taking turns on this Betty male right here.
Oh.
Oh.
Hold on. Oh! He's striking at it. He's getting mad.
He's fired up. Gills are flaring out.
Yeah.
Mouth wide open.
The more Matt's turn.
The more erratic you give it to him, the more he wants to come after it.
So oftentimes when the fish is locked down in a bed, you keep shaking that lure and irritating him. It'll fire him up even more to protect. Put your butt over here.
Here it comes.
Oh, boom! Oh, I was waiting for that blow in.
He dropped it right before the hook set.
Yep. Oh, that's it. That's it right there. Now, you see what Matt's doing right there? How that fish, when he hooked it, that's a little better than I thought it was. Whoop, come here. Safe. There we go. Upper twos, little chunky guy to get it started off with.
Boy, he was fired up, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was fired. So all the fish that we're catching on beds today, we're going to put right back in. If it was a pre-spawn fish, a fish that we caught out here off the docks, I would put it in the live well for a final day picture for you. But if we're catching them off beds, we're getting our picture and we're putting them right back down. 10, 15 minutes, that fish will go right back to doing his business and we don't negatively affect that spawning cycle. It's a real good thing to do if... You know, unless you're trying to do something for sponsors, holding up a couple big fish, then I understand. Or if you're in a tournament, do not bypass that fish. Catch that fish. Otherwise, don't fish tournaments because everybody else is bed fishing. But, you know, if you get a picture, hold them in, get the camera ready, get that picture, let that fish go. Come back in 15 minutes and you will see for yourself. Everybody says it does so much harm to these fish. No, it doesn't. You rarely ever screw them up too bad to where it's going to throw them off their spawning cycle, right?
Yeah, absolutely not. Yeah, most of the time you'll see a fish go right back to the bed almost immediately.
Yeah, no, exactly. I mean, just out back behind my house, hell, I caught, I taught my buddy how to bed fish on one fish I caught from the day before, and then I went out there and I had my daughter. I cast that plug up there, shook it, the fish still bites, the fish looks clean. I squeezed down the barb just so we can keep catching the same fish, but... Yeah, it does way little harm if you just let them go right away, guys. So a lot of the time when you're looking for bed fish, especially in a tournament scenario, if you're out pre-fishing, you want to utilize as much time as possible without just slowly moving it 2 miles an hour down the bank to not spook a bed fish. A lot of the time, if you're just in tight, cruise until you see them. When you see that fish swimming off, then find the bed, get a better perspective, turn out wider, and then stay off the fish. A lot of the time you're gonna track down a whole lot more beds that way, and then once you back off, you know that fish is going to come right back over to that bed. Instead of taking your sweet time where you're going to be spinning your wheels and sucking up time throughout that day, precious time, instead of just burning down, see them, they swim off, back off, they come right back over to the bed. They want to protect the bed, so they will be back. You see it? Oh, yeah, she is on it.
Go ahead. That's her spot right there, that hole.
Right there.
My tube jig is completely ruined. So.
I see it spinning.
Yeah, so it's not going to be good. Watch out for the feeders in the parking
lot. I think she's right here, bro.
No, she's right here.
Is she over there?
She's still chilling. Right here.
Oh, yeah, okay. Fat wacky rig.
Oh, there she is.
She's going to spit it. That's a better one. It's about 4 pounds. 3¾. There we go.
They come off that thing really.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she's taking over. She's taking the boat.
Oh, shoot. Hang on. She's not messing around. She's still mad.
She's still mad. Now, that's a better fish there.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Yeah.
Boy, she played hard to get, didn't she?
What was that, about 30 minutes?
30 minutes.
Yeah.
To put that in the boat. And she was active the whole entire time.
She's a catch and release fish, too. Look at the top lip.
Yep.
Show them that. Testament to catch and release fishing.
There you go.
Nice recovered hole. Healthy fish.
Perfect.
Big girl down there spawning. We'll let her go.
We're going to put her back so she can go back to her bed.
About mid-threes. So. That's a 3, 4, 5 and a half range for two fish.
Yeah.
Good start for the first 45 minutes of the day.
Perfect. There's nothing.
Oh, I forgot. We caught that other bed fish too. So, no, wait. We got my two. That one. Okay, yeah. We got three fish already.
We're sitting about 8.5, 9 pounds.
Yeah, good start. Good start.
Not bad.
We're going to upgrade.
Yeah. What we're trying to do here is we're trying to get these fish a little fired up with the, I don't know if you can see that down there, but we're the tube jig, we're getting it real erratic and real quick. A lot of times it'll trigger the fish to get a little more angry, maybe a little more intense. And we'll just do it over and over and over until you get some sort of reaction. And sometimes you don't, but a lot of the time that's what's going to get you to catch the fish.
Yeah, talk about
what we're doing here is throwing a rate of fall 12 Huddleston in this bed, trying to get this thing fired up for Nick to have a good shot at her. I typically don't like to catch them on it, but some of the bigger ones I will. But this HUD is a great way to get him bid on that little jig. She'll get fired up enough to where she don't want to have to deal with two baits at one time, and she'll take that one right out of there if she's worried about this one coming back.
Yeah.
And she's getting fired up on it pretty good, actually. She doesn't like it in there at all.
Hang with us, guys. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, did you know that Yours Truly is now hosting Lucky Tackle Box's monthly panfish instructionals? And aside from relentless fish catching, I'll be breaking down the rigging and the gear you need to get going along the way. And of course, a few extra tips to help you score more fish on the goodies included in your box. So remember, the tug is our drug. So go visit LuckyTackleBox.com and get signed up today. Are you into diving, surfing, or fishing? And have you checked out the Salt Life YouTube channel yet? From awesome surfing insight to scuba diving locations and in and offshore fishing, bundled up with all sorts of crazy cool footage, the Salt Life has you ocean lovers covered. So go check out their YouTube channel and tell them IF sent you. Ever tried pulling a planer board next to your boat when trolling or fishing from a swift current bank? If not, you're missing out on one of the most phenomenal fish catching machines on the market today. With Yellowbird planer boards pulling your lines perpendicular to your boat, you can't help but catch more fish. Find out more by visiting www.yellowbirdproducts.com. Did you know that B-Line makes specialized lines for all your fishing needs? From the super strong abrasive resistant CXX or the low stretch super stealthy CX Premium, or maybe you're looking for invisibility or super bite detection with B-Line's 100% fluorocarbon. No matter what your needs, P-Line's got it covered. To find out more, visit P-Line.com.
P-Line, baby!
Did you ever wish for an RC boat when you were a kid? And do you have a passion for fishing? Well, guess what? It's time to do them both at the same time. With RCFishingWorld.com's RC Fishing Pole, it's time to be a kid again. So visit www.RCFishingWorld.com today. Oh, you heard they got weapons of big fish destruction? Well, you heard right. BWA Fishing Performance is the newest company hitting the U.S. market by storm. With some of the sickest swim baits around and non-cookie-cutter style lures that you could ever get your hands on, it's time to show these fish something new. Visit BWA.com. Attention Northern California anglers, have you been to Boat Country in Escalon with one of the largest selections of welded aluminum fishing boats from North River, Hughes Craft, and now Crestliner? Chances are they have the right boat for you. And did I mention they have a full service center to take care of all your repair or boating maintenance needs? If you're a boat owner or just looking to become one, you owe it to yourself to check these guys out. Visit BoatCountryUSA.com or stop on by. We'll see you there. So after targeting those bedfish in and around the marina, Matt and I decided to target some standing timber just outside of those spawning flats. A lot of the time your pre-spawn fish are gonna move into those trees just adjacent to those flats during the pre-spawn and in the post-spawn. So if you see a lot of empty beds, you might wanna try targeting those trees. That's why I was throwing the big rat over it. I missed one probably around 5 or 6 pounds on the rat, but after that we really didn't get a lot more strikes.
Smallmouth, yeah. Smallie on a bed. Hold that for me, sir. Woo, he's got that. Got it in the bottom lip. Now he doesn't. Little nice light colored bronze back. Nice red eyes on him. Woo, and he stinks. That's my favorite. Like them when they stink, Matt. Let's let them go. Yeah, baby. Had to go ultra finesse on this dude. Now I'm only on 6 pound line here, so I'm just taking my sweet time. Wanna lift that one for me, Matt?
Yeah, why not?
Jump. He's a little better than I thought he was.
He loves digging. Oh, come here. There he is.
Yeah, it's a little bit better fish right there. Not bad.
And when he says ultralight, he's not kidding around. Look at that.
1/32 ounce jig head.
Look at the size of that hook with that fish. I just learned something right there, guys.
It works.
Awesome. You want to at least touch your fish?
Yeah, hold on. Let me smell it.
Oh, yeah. Nice and stinky. It's getting better. As long as they stink, you know the day's going to get better. Adios, amigo.
See, now that's a cakewalk right there, you know. Pulling. There we go. Quick release. I was trying to boat flip that one. When they're only about a pound, I'm going to go for the boat flip. Save myself the effort. There's a good one. All right, guys, so we found those bedfish earlier now near the south end of the lake over by the marina, and we ran over to a spot that Matt's normally really familiar with of where bedfish show up. But the thing is, we got so much algae growth and so much carp in there, we couldn't find a single bass, so we've been checking a lot of flats over here in the north end of the lake. Occasionally I was throwing the BWAS submission, and I had 4 smallies come up, 2 track it, and 2 of them hit it and short strike it. So now I got Matt throwing the A-rig with a bunch of submissions on there, and I'm throwing the single one while we still search for beds. We're looking for that little bit cleaner water, trying to find those largies up there on those flats. So we're jumping from flat to flat to flat, and as we're covering the water looking, we're throwing this single submission on a little kill weighted hook like that, Texas rigged, and the A rig. So what we got going on here is there's a bunch of old Christmas trees that they built, put out here for fish shelter. Some of them suspended, some of them are anchored down, and now that the wind's calmed down a little bit, we pulled in between them, and we found a nice pair of bass. Both of them look to be like in a 3 pound class. One of them maybe pushing a little bit over 4 down along the side of a log. And some of the setups we've been using have exposed hooks, and then other ones, like a white jig right here, the heavy duty, you know, extra strength hook right there, 1/2 ounce white jig on 65 pound braid is the ideal setup for this heavy cover. I've got my drag locked down. I stick this fish right in between three Christmas trees that are 4 feet above it. I need to be able to put that fish in four-wheel drive and come straight out and boat flip her right away. She wraps around one of these logs out here, even with this braid, it's done. It's hooked and done. So you have to jam them, burn them in, boat flip them right away. But that's the setup for this, these bigger trees like this, a big white jig or any sort of bright color jig, so you can really pay attention when it's down there on the bottom. As soon as you see that white disappear, drill them.
That is such a big fish.
Yeah, she's in the teens, bro. She's huge.
She's a teener. Let's see
So we found a fish that's probably 12 to 13 pound female. There's about a 5 pound buck with her. They're not locked down to the beds, and they're not showing any interest in even the bigger jig. So Matt's got a Huddleston Deluxe tied on here, and just parking it to try to show them something absolutely large invading their space. A lot of the time the big female bass will come up and smack a big trout bait like this. You know, so we're looking around, we don't see a pronounced bed, but there's an absolute giant.
As we got a fish here, Nick mentioned it earlier, she's about 12, 13 pounds, could even push 14 pounds. You know, this fish, typically any other size fish, we probably would have left already. She's a very difficult fish to catch. The stage that she's in is just kind of all over the place. She did show some interest in the HUD. She followed it back to the boat a couple times. She kind of turned on it a couple times. But now she's kind of in a stage where she's not wanting to even show up even when the boat's anywhere near us. There's about a 4 pound male. He's about the same stage. And this will probably give us a little bit longer, but honestly, this is one of those ones you're probably just going to have to remember because she's not going to come in the boat by the looks of it. But boy, it's one of the biggest bass I've seen in the last 4 or 5 years. And I wish we could get her on video here, but she's still swimming in here. We're going to give her a little bit longer and see what happens. As you can see, guys, she's right here in front. Turning to the left and going out. Yeah, she's all of 13. And there's the male. She's about 6 inches wide across the back. Looks like probably about 27, 28, 29 inches long.
All right, guys, so we were jumping around to everything that matched our conditions for where we found bed fish. After finding that big girl, spending a little bit of time trying to get her to go, we found a couple other little tiny ones, but nothing worth showing. So now we're going to search around, go fish some deeper stuff, and just try to fish, you know, hopefully some pre-spawn fish that we can find. This lake is very difficult, but we're going to try to catch one or two more fish for you and break down what we're doing to try to get those. So just hang with us.
This is 100 mile an hour for this lake right here.
Right, so we moved over to the deeper section. Matt throwing a walking bait, and one thing I like to do just to find fish, that's a pretty little smallmouth there. Gorgeous colors on them. Real pretty little guy, look how clean that is. Doesn't have the red eyes like the other one, but gorgeous colors. What I like to do is take like little crappie jigs and paint them out black or buy the black ones. And when the water's clear, I'll take these brown zoom trick worms and hook it on there. And just basically like a little ball head jig, and I'll bring it up and I'll pitch it up to the wall and I'll kind of tight line it, kind of getting it to pendulum away to where the hook point stays up. But at the same time, I'll let it follow the contour of the wall so it's coming down to the wall. And in the spring like this, a lot of the fish are associated right to the banks or right up against those walls. So that little ball head just darting off of there and coming down is going to get you a whole lot of bites. Plus this rig probably all together is less than a quarter, so I mean if you break it off, no big deal. I'll spend $5 a day breaking these off strictly for how many bites I'm going to get, and that's just to hone the fish down. If you start catching a lot of fish that way, you know, you might want to pick up a jig or something a little bit bigger and go to try to get those bigger bites at that point.
That's that rig I'm using right there.
Is that a big bass?
I think so, bro.
Dude, that's like a
yeah, that's... No, she's coming to your bait.
Oh my, this one right here.
Yeah.
Is that a bass?
I'm pretty sure, dude.
If that's a bass, that's another teener, dude.
I think it is.
There's just something else down here.
I don't know what that is down here.
I don't know, but that big bass.
That one has interest in your bait, yeah. Another little guy.
Shmoomouth! Just the cast before this, it felt a little pick. That's exactly what it was, little smallies, but it's two strikes in a row. Not bad. Jeez.
Popping me.
It's getting pretty close.
Yeah, I mean, it's about the same size. I'm fishing for lure-sized fish, and Matt's fishing for fish that can eat the fish that I'm catching. But I'm having fun now.
He's coming, Matt. He's coming over the edge of the boat.
Jump up and nail Matt in the leg.
Well, there's the snake. He's trying to get in the boat.
Type.
We caught him.
Okay, in the comments section, guys, type what snake this is. And it is not a Senko. It's a gorgeous little snake, though.
He's kind of a reddish-colored snake.
He's not pooping, so he's not a gardener snake.
Just bit me in the hand, so hopefully he's not poisonous.
Why is he rattling his tail? Maybe we should drop trout that thing?
Oh boy.
Hey, you should Instagram that catch, dude. That's one of the best things we've caught here today.
Yeah, absolutely.
Swimming across the lake.
So what kind of snake is that, Matt?
What are you going with?
Oh boy, I don't know.
Python?
Oh yeah.
Bull?
Maybe.
Bull
maybe.
Python?
Maybe.
Yeah, some sort of python.
Definitely.
From the python genus.
Has a little mouth open.
Oh, yeah. Mouth that thing,
I think
thing,
he might
Matt.
Be a little mad. This little guy stayed with us for about, I don't know, what's it been, like 5-10 minutes?
At least.
At least swimming behind the boat, so we thought we'd bring him in the boat and say hi a little bit.
All right, let's toss him back.
All right, here he goes.
Quick release.
Boom! Oh, bought him. He got him. He got bought him. He bought him. He's got bottom on. Bottom on. Oh. Well, guys, that's it. I mean, we smashed him on beds pretty early, Matt, right? You know, got a few pretty good fish. And I think for up here this time of year, probably what, low teens we probably ended up with?
Yeah. Yeah, probably. Yeah, I think we're right 14, 15 pounds. Right
14, there. 15 pounds. Yeah, that's not bad. I mean, I was also throwing the big rat. I had one roll on it, probably about 6 pounds. Matt was throwing the big waiver, right?
Yeah, yeah. Remember CS waiver, the 200.
Yeah, the big one.
Yeah.
And a big old 7-8 pounder rolled on that, just came unpegged, didn't get it all the way. And, I mean, that's just the way it goes. And then we seen that 13-pounder on a bed. So if you think if the stars magically lined up and two of those fish hooked up and that 13-pounder was on a bed, you could only imagine the type of day you can have at a place like this. 10-mile-an-hour speed limit lake, smaller lake. Not a lot of pressure. You know, these bay, I guess this is considered the Bay Area still, right? Yeah.
Livermore? Right in between.
Right in between, like kind of. Yeah, man, but you guys can come out here. I mean, your tube jig, that was probably bed fishing tool of the day.
Yeah, they were looking for it real sporadic and real quick, you know, yeah. So that it darts real quick and it's an easy bait to control. So,
yeah.
You know, that's everything when you're bed fishing.
Yeah, how heavy a line you throwing that on?
Shoot, I had actually was throwing that on 50-pound braid.
50-pound braid on the spinning rod, because when you see Matt boat flip that one earlier,
yeah.
I'm like, I didn't realize he had braid on there. I thought he was about to break that. But I'm like, oh, wait, he knows what he's doing. Of course he knows what he's doing. And it's just like, oh, man, but then I realized he had the braid on there. With the opposite of what I did, a lot of the time when I'm getting short pegged by fish, I put on that little tiny crappie jig and a little tiny bright bait. I mean, the brightest colors you want when you're bed fishing, these fish are just coming up and defending their bed. They're not looking to get a meal. So don't keep that in mind. Matt, once again, brother,
yeah,
I greatly appreciate
lot,
you coming out. You know, it's always a good time when we're out with this guy. We're going to go out and smash him with Matt all the time. Matt's a good buddy.
Yep.
Plus, we're like twins, I guess.
Yeah.
Everybody thinks Matt's me or I'm Matt or
yeah,
something.
I had to grow a goatee so we stopped getting the twin thing.
He's the evil if because he has the goatee and I don't have it. All right, brother. I appreciate you guys watching. InformativeFisherman.com. What's your Facebook?
My Facebook?
Yep.
It's MattFrazier.com, and then Instagram is Frazier Luck Fishing.
Frazier Luck, Matt Frazier Undercover Sportsman is your title sponsor, right?
Absolutely.
Make sure to check these items out. That's the bed cover right there, right?
Yeah, bed cover and the swing out cases.
Absolutely awesome stuff, guys. We will see you next time. Appreciate it.